How to pray. I titled this message with a big reason, because a lot of people and a lot of God's people are having a question: why is it that I'm praying for many years but my prayer doesn't come to pass? Why is it that I'm crying unto the Lord but there seems not to be a solution? Well, because there are some conditions blocking or delaying our answers from the Lord. Issues, I will label them one by one. First of all, I will start pointing out the first one, which is sin. Sin is the most thing that hides God's face from us. Sin is the most thing that reduces God's hand to help us. That will lead me to Isaiah 59 verse number 2. But your iniquities, in short your sins, have separated you from God, and your sins have hidden his face from, so that he will not hear you, thus says the Lord. Watch this. If your Bible is yours, underline the word here, where God says your sins are the one that separate you from him not to hear your prayers. That is one of the reasons why some of our prayers are not answered. We've been praising and praising because you did not accept Christ in you, or either because sin is so too much that brings and that brought a blockage between you and God. There is a roadblock between you and God. There is no communication. It's like network cut off. There is no reaching out to God. Secondly, is a relationship you have with God. If you look at the story of Job, look, Job was so recognized in God's eyes. That's why when Satan came to God to accuse him, God asked him, "Did you consult my servant Job?" Which means God knew Job personally. Now the question is, does God know you from the inside and outside? Does God have a relationship with you? Does God talk to you regularly? There are some situations where some of us, we are so far away from God. The day you have spoken to God is 1984, when your son was in an accident. That's the only day when you spoke to God. After 20 years is now when you want to come to God again when problem comes. That's the relationship you have with God, that the one limiting your answers. You will find such factors are the one that draw God's hand off us. Thirdly, is the motive, the reason behind your prayer. The Bible says we cannot receive because we ask with wrong motives. Sometimes you are so broke, or let me say you are broken. You are broken more than Moses when you broke the Ten Commandments. You are so broke, and then you are asking, demanding from God, "Lord, please enrich me and bless me with a certain amount of money." The reason behind it is because you want to propose and say, so that they might see, so that they might recognize me, so that, yeah, they will now see, "Lord, please help me to win this competition, so that those who call Joe from our village will see." See, such wrong motives are the one preventing us not to receive from the Lord. Or sometimes when you pray for somebody, you are so pressing hard so that the Lord might answer your prayer, because you want glory, you want honor to be added unto your name, you want to be glorified, and you want to be well known that this man can pray so that results can come out within a second. You want your name to be lifted up. That's why sometimes our prayers are not answered, because we pray with the wrong motives. Fourthly, doubt. James chapter number 1 verse 6 is telling me, "But ask in faith with no doubt. For he who doubts is like a wave of the sea driven and tossed by the wind. For let not that man suppose that he will receive anything from the Lord." Look, the Bible says, any such a man who asks from within with doubt, he must forget, he will not receive anything. For the Bible is again telling me, faith is the object that pleases God. We are saved through faith, we are justified through faith, we are called through faith, and we are blessed through faith. Only faith can move God's heart. Only faith can move God's direction towards you. Only faith can draw God's hand towards you. Only faith can draw God's attention towards you. By faith, we can access and we can receive whatever we ask. John 14:14 is telling you, whatever soever you ask in my name, you shall believe. When you believe, you shall receive. That is only when you apply faith to that such requesting that you're asking from the Lord.
Thank you.
The last one, it is faith which is applied in your words when you ask it.
He loves you.
Faith. I will describe faith like this. You know, when a cell phone is programmed, when you press a green button, when there is an incoming call, it will answer. It's a fact, when you press the button, it will display on the screen answer because it is programmed like that. Or when you press the zero button, it will display a zero on the screen. It is programmed.